हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू दिस ई लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ गलगोटियाज यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम प्रखर भार्गव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट गलगोटियाज यूनिवर्सिटी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मास कम्युनिकेशन। इन दिस सेशन ऑफ लाइट एंड कैमरा लैब वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वॉट आर द की सेटिंग्स इन अ DSLR कैमरा विच विल हेल्प यू टू प्रोड्यूस गुड क्वालिटी पिक्चर्स एंड वीडियोज बाई यूजिंग अ DSLR। सो लेट्स बिगिन द सेशन।
Action.
So let's begin the discussion further, and we will now try to learn the basic and important functionalities available in a DSLR in order to capture an image properly and to store it. So we will go to this menu button, and we will first try to locate how to format the memory card. Here we have lot of button and lot of functionalities. First we have this camera setting mode, where we have lot of options to set many things. First we will go to the setting where we will locate our memory card, and we will learn how to format it. Here in this settings tab we have these numbers. Here it shows format the memory card. You just have to press OK and it will format the memory card you have entered. As I have told you before, that this DSLR camera particularly have options of entering two memory cards separately. So it will show you those options, that which card you want to format. The smaller card which we have entered in this camera right now is located on the second option, and the CF card, the bigger card, is located on the first option. Okay, so here you can format the card and it will erase all the data stored in this card. Let's learn about some more settings which we need to adjust before clicking the photograph. One of the basic and most important things to adjust before clicking or start capturing through this DSLR is to set the image quality. And so as to adjust this image quality, you have this first tab where it shows image quality, and it has multiple options. Here it shows JPEG and JPEG qualities which you want to capture, large photo. Here you can see in this small numbers here, it shows the capacity of a memory card that you have entered, and depending upon the size of your photograph, see here it on the smaller size photograph, the quality decreases, and the number of photograph you can store in this memory card almost doubled. This is a relatively low quality photograph where you have almost 10,000 photograph storing capacity in this memory card. As we go along, this is S1, S2, and many more settings. You can also adjust the RAW setting, where you can capture RAW photos. Here you will see only 625 RAW photos will be captured in this camera if we set it to this RAW mode. Here you can also adjust the image quality depending upon the RAW and JPEG file size. The main difference being RAW captures larger photos and preserves all its information intact, whereas JPEG photos are relatively smaller and little processed in the camera itself. Okay, so after this we have another options in which we can adjust if we want to review the image we have just captured. If we turn this on for about 2 seconds, you can see how it changes the image review process. Here we have this similar subject. If we press the shutter button half, it will focus, and if we press it completely, it will capture the photograph. And because we have enabled the camera review image review button. Okay, so now we will try and understand the different types of menu settings in this recording mode. First, in the order to change this recording settings, we have to adjust our camera from the still photography mode to the video mode. this is a live view mode of still photography mode. Then when we change the camera by pressing this button or sliding this button to the recording mode, we have these options. As you can see, the aspect ratio have changed, and this again shows this AM button, manual mode with a camcorder sign. It shows our camera is now in a recording mode. We will go to the menu option to change the settings, and the main thing we have to keep in mind while capturing a video through this DSLR is the movie record quality, and what type of according to the requirement we have, we need to change this setting first. Here we have the first setting, movie record size and movie the type of recording. We can set it to MOV or MP4, whichever you like. Next thing we have is the movie recording size. This is the important setting that we need to keep in mind. We have multiple options here, starting from full HD video recording at 50 FPS, 50 frames per second, to full HD video recording with a better quality, slightly better quality. Then we have full HD video recording at 25 frames per second. Next is we have full HD video recording at 25 FPS with all eye, that means a little better quality. Also, this camera offers 4K video recording at 25 frames per second, which is significantly much better in quality, but it is only available here in 25 frames per second. Now, different camera setups offers different types of video recording options. According to the camera setup and according to your need, you need to adjust this frames per second and the quality of your video recording. Okay, so we will, for now on, we will set it to full HD 25 frames per second. Here you can use 24 frames, enable or disable. It will restrict your frame rate strictly to 24 FPS. Okay, so the next thing here is the sound recording options. In most of the cases, if you are recording a video with an external mic or external sound recording facility, you can enable or disable this option by going into this menu. Now your video will be recorded without any sound. You can also adjust it accordingly by setting it on the manual mode, where you can adjust the recording level, the level at which your camera automatically captures the sound. Here, as you can see, as we slide this option towards the left side, the audio recording, the level of audio recording decreases. We can also increase this by sliding this on the right side. You can also set your camera on sound recording level on auto mode, where your camera decides at what level it needs to capture the audio along with the visuals you are providing. Okay. So once we have set this mode, we have this option of video screen. We can we can start recording by pressing this button, start and stop. Here our video is being recorded. It will show the time, and this red dot will denote that the video is continuously recording. To stop this video, we again need to press this button and the video will be saved. There are few more settings in this still, in both for still photography mode and video mode, which are to access all the settings available here. You need to go to this queue options, which takes you to individual settings. You can adjust ISO, shutter speed and aperture as well, your exposure triangle. Also, you can go to this menu, where you can set your options to shoot single photo or continuous mode. Here You can adjust this to high speed continuous photographs. It will click photographs at a higher speed continuously, depending upon the frame rate at which your camera can click. This is a low speed continuous shot. Also, you can set it on a timer where your camera will start clicking a photograph after certain amount of time that you set. For example, if we have set the camera on self timer of 2 seconds, we can enable this. And now when we go to capture the photograph, here it will focus the object, and as we press the button, it will capture the object after 2 seconds or after the amount of time that you have set in this option. Let's see what are the other options we have. Here you can also use a remote where you can use the remote to capture the photograph from a distance. You can also change this time here. You can also set it to 10 seconds and you can use the remote here as well. So these are the basic functionalities you need to know about your camera while photographing or recording a video. So these are the key settings that one must know while operating a DSLR camera so as to produce good quality pictures and videos. This is all in today's session. For any types of doubt and queries, you can contact me on this email ID and phone number. With another session, we will meet again in this course of Light and Camera Lab. Thank you. Thank you all for joining.